people don't like dust blowing through their screen doors from a farmer's field. So that's where the conservation tillage, keeping land covered year round with cash crop, perennial grass, or cover crop is big. The principles are the same no matter where you are. Getting perennial grasses back in your operation with some type of livestock. I'm Joel Love. I work with the University of Florida, Office Extension, and I'm a BMP Outreach Education Coordinator working with farmers.
We have a cattle and peanut sod-based rotation, harvest grass seed and hay. William Cart, Stonewall Farms. Basically, the farmer operation has been revolves around the cattle operation. We're strictly a dry land farming operation, no irrigation. We do strip till farming with our peanuts. We do peanuts there for 3 years, where we run the vertical tillage that we implemented last year. We run a vertical tillage and then we strip till our peanuts in and using a high residue cultivator to help with weed control. And then we'll do that for 3 years and then we'll rotate back to grass. To sod for the cattle.
William Card is an example. He's one of our progressive farmers here in Suwanee County is doing strip till and planting cover crops. But probably the thing that William has embraced the most is trying to incorporate cattle and perennial grasses in his rotation. And we see a tremendous acceleration of soil health improvement when you integrate cattle and bahia grass, for example, here.
Yeah, all these implementations that we're doing as far as the conservation and the, trying to help our water quality, we're doing everything that we can do possible and trying to implement these programs to help our water quality because the water's everybody's. We're trying to do everything we can on our side so that we do have a good water source and can maintain that quality of water.